Today, we're gonna use an empty cardboard box so that we can discuss the invisible world. Natural gas. That's right, we're talking about methane. And if everything goes correctly, we won't need one of these. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey guys, it's Jason Latimer, world champion in magic, and we're here with the Ventura County Fire Department. Firefighter Mike is gonna show us the most terrifying balloon I've ever seen, a balloon full of natural gas.
We'll also check out how firefighters learn how to interact with this crazy invisible substance. But first, we have to go back in time. Millions, if not hundreds of millions of years ago, the remains of dead plants and animals made up a thick layer across the Earth's surface, if not ocean's floor. Now, with sand and silt and calcium carbonate, with the heat and pressure deep below the Earth, those remains transformed into what we call fossil fuels. Now, there's coal, there's petroleum, and there's natural gas. Now, within natural gas, there's a few different types. There's ethane, there's propane, there's butane, and the most popular one that we use in our homes is methane. So, with this invisible gas, I thought we'd take a close look
at the invisible world of methane.
Normally in your house, you take the bubbles out, and what do? Do they go up or down at home?
They usually go down.
They go down, right? Well, these are different bubbles.
Do not try this at home.
Now, methane on its own is invisible, which is why we add mercaptan to it to make it more detectable so that we can smell it. But we do know if there was a leak, it'd be rising up to the ceiling because it's less dense than air, much like the bubbles were rising up to the ceiling. But when we lit the bubbles on fire, they burned red and yellow and orange versus our stove burned blue. So what's the difference? It has to do with the invisible mixture of methane and oxygen. This is called the flammability limit. Under 5% methane, it's gonna be too lean. It's not even gonna be flammable. But between 5 and 15%, that's the sweet spot for methane, where it's gonna burn the hottest at around 1960 degrees. After 15%, it starts burning too rich, and you're gonna get those red, oranges, and yellows, and it's gonna be less hot. It's gonna be about 1,000 degrees Celsius. Now, the problem with this is it's an invisible mixture, and if you didn't know what mixture you're dealing with, you have a very dangerous situation on your hands. So check this out. We filled a cardboard box with pure methane, and we put a small hole in the top and made an opening on the side. When firefighter Mike holds a flame above the hole in the top, the escaping gas ignites, but the gas only ignites where the ratio of methane is within its flammability limit. Since natural gas is lighter than air, it continues to escape out the top of the box, and as it burns off, more and more air is entering the chamber below until it reaches that explosive limit within the chamber. Then, kaboom! So, if we had a pocket of 100% methane gas and it was lit on fire, it should burn red and yellow as it rises. Now, much like every experiment we've done today, do not try this at home.
So, firefighter Mike, tell me what we're doing today.
So, right here, we have a balloon full of natural gas, which is a mixture of methane and mercaptan. The mercaptan is what gives its odorant. The biggest physical property you want to show here is that it is less dense than the air around it. So it actually floats, which is an important safety feature of natural gas. It just sits above you, it rises away. So if you were in this building, if we filled it full of propane, which is heavier than air, which is more dense than the air, it would sink and it could settle in places and it stays there longer. Oh, with this, if I walk outside or I open up a window, the gas itself is gonna dissipate.
Just knowing that alone is very helpful. They come in colors.
So when the balloon pops, the methane is no longer contained and spreads quickly across the ceiling. It also burns a bright red and yellow, which means the mixture of methane to oxygen was over 15%.
Whoa!
Let's see that again. Whoa! That is so hot.
Well, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed learning about the invisible world of natural gas. And I want to give a huge thank you to the Ventura County Fire Department for helping me out on this episode.
If you enjoy learning about the impossible topics and invisible worlds that are around us, let me know. Click the like button, share the video with your friends. And if you like learning about my crazy experiments, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.
What are you doing?
We're doing the dishes. You aren't gonna help me?
Of course, of course. Impossible Science dishwasher.
Yeah, yeah.